Hello everyone and welcome to VAN Tech Corner. In today's video, we are going to set up PPPoE connection with VLAN. Some of the internet service providers run their internet service on a specific VLAN. For example, Unifi from Malaysia runs their PPPoE server on VLAN 500 and Viettel from Vietnam runs their PPPoE server on VLAN 35. In this tutorial, I'm using Viettel, therefore I will be setting up the PPPoE client on VLAN 35. If your internet service provider runs all the service on this single GPON routers from optical converter to PPPoE client, just like this, you need to ask your internet service provider to help you and then switch this router to bridge mode. And if your internet service provider have two devices, one is a modem and one is a router, just like this one from TAM Malaysia, then you don't need to configure the router to bridge mode, but you can directly plug this modem to the OpenWRT router and configure it. In this case, the GPON routers have been switched to bridge mode, so we can proceed with the OpenWRT configuration. As you can see from the dashboard, I am currently using the D-Link DIR-A42C2. So let's go to network, switch. Right, at this switch management page, you will have two VLAN, VLAN 1 for your LAN interfaces and VLAN number 2 for your WAN interface. We need VLAN 35, therefore we are going to change it. VLAN ID from 2 to 35. You can give it some name, maybe internet, and then go to your WAN port status and change to tag it, right? After we done, hit save and apply. Once you done, everything should look like this, right? So let's go to network interfaces. So this is our WAN interfaces, and you can see the Ethernet 0.2 has been changed to Ethernet 0.35. 35 is the VLAN ID. And then we need to click on the edit button and then change the protocol to PPPoE. Click switch protocol. Fill in the PAP or the CHAP username and password provided by your internet service provider. If you don't know, you can call them and check with them. After we're done with the username and password, go to advanced setting. Everything look right on the physical setting. Make sure it is on interface Ethernet 0.35. And on the firewall setting, make sure it is assigned to the WAN firewall zone. Hit save and then save and apply. Now let's plug in the Ethernet cable to the WAN port. As you can see, we have received the IPv4 and IPv6 from our internet service provider, and there is package going on the WAN interface, and it's time to run the speed test. I am currently using the dynamic IP address, that's why I don't hide it from you. So after I reboot the modem, I will get a new IP address. So yeah, it's no point to get my IP address stay below 115.79.258.51. Alright, so we have a working internet connection and it is time to set up our wireless interfaces. Let's go to network, wireless, And then we have two radios, one for the 2.4 GHz and one for the 5 GHz Wi-Fi. Click the add button, and then this is the wireless AC, so we can put it something like OpenWRT 5G or the network section stack LAN device, because we want to attach our wireless interface to our LAN network. On the wireless security, we can give it a password. So it could be something like this. All right. On the advanced settings, we can leave everything there. Right, everything load right. Hit save and that's it. And we will do the same for the 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi. Click the add button and then select the LAN interfaces, give it a password. And then hit save. Lastly, hit save and apply. Looks great. Let's mute the phone and connect it to it. My phone has just connected to the wireless station, and we can see an associated station show right there down below. So far, we have just set up PPPoE client on the OpenWRT router with VLAN. If there are any questions or idea, feel free to leave it in the comment section and we will try to go through it. And as always, if you see the video helpful, please like, share and subscribe to the channel to support me. Thanks for watching, and I will be see you all in the next video. Just one more thing before we end the video. If you are running OpenWRT on the x86 computer which has only two network ports, there will be no switch management page. Let's say that your LAN interface is Ethernet 0 and your WAN interface is Ethernet 1. Then you can create a WAN interface. Alright, so something just like this. You go to this add new interface, and then on the name you can put something like internet, right? And then on the protocol you can put it something like PPPoE. And then on the interfaces, you need to specify your own interface. If your one interface is Ethernet 1, right, and you are set up your VLAN 35 on this one interface, then you need to add 35 and then hit enter, right, and click create interface, and then assign it to the one zone, and just like what we did previously, and this should be fine. Alright, so just a small tip for x86 users. That's all. Goodbye.